All right, hello Algebra 2. Today we're going to look at 8.5. This is our third lesson over 8.5. And this will cover simplifying complex fractions. And complex fractions involve a fraction within a fraction. Now, actually, let's get that down. Complex fractions contain a fraction within a fraction. Now there's a couple ways to solve these. I'm going to stick with one method in particular, but let me get an example down and I'll talk about it. Our instructions are to simplify, and we have 6 over x minus 5 plus 1 over x. And we've seen a problem like that before in our addition and subtraction section, but this is all divided by 3 over x minus 2 over x minus 5. Now, one way to do this would be, and it wouldn't be a bad way to do it if this was a little more simple, one way to do this would be to simplify your numerator, get a common denominator, simplify your numerator, get a common denominator, simplify your denominator, and then rewrite this as multiplying by the reciprocal. Multiply by the reciprocal. And that works pretty well on a lot of problems. But I'm going to approach this in a consistent manner. And I'm going to do, let me grab my marker real quick. I'm going to approach this from the perspective of I'm going to eliminate my extra fractions, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply by the common denominator of everything. So right here we've got an x minus 5. That's going to be one of my factors. I've got an x, another x, and another x minus 5. So my common denominator of everything would be x minus 5 and x. Now, what would be the benefit of multiplying by that? Well, when you multiply by the common denominator, your current denominators are going to divide out, and you're going to end up with a simpler fraction. Now, I can't just multiply the numerator. I've got to multiply the denominator as well, because I'm really just multiplying by 1. And because we have this addition and subtraction, I do have to distribute. So it's going to go across like this and like this. Same thing on the bottom. All right, now notice how this works. When the x minus 5 times x multiplies here, the x minus 5s divide out. And you're left with a 6 and an x. When this x minus 5 times 5 multiplies with this 1 over x, the x's divide out, and you're left with an x minus 5. Now we move to our denominator. Same sort of setup. X minus 5 times x multiplies here, the x's go away, and then we're left with a 3 that would then distribute with the x minus 5. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. 3x minus 15. I get nervous sometimes with this negative. I'm going to go ahead and do plus negative. May not be an issue, but I like to be on the safe side. When this multiplies here, the x minus 5's divide out, we're left with a negative 2x. Now from here, class, notice we multiplied by our common denominator of all the little fractions. Now we got a non-complex fraction, a normal sort of rational expression. But we do have a little bit of work to do, don't we? Let's combine like terms. Combine like terms. And I do have to warn you, it is possible that at the end of your problem, that the rational expression, rational expression that you have might simplify. So just kind of double check, does it factor? Nope, nothing factors, so we are good. All right, let's move on. 5 over x plus 4 divided by 1 over x plus 4 plus 2 over x. Complex fraction, we've got fractions within a fraction. Let's multiply by the common denominator, and after doing so, it'll be nicer. We need an x plus 4. We already got an x plus 4 and an x. We have to distribute across here. X plus 4 is divided out. We're left with an x. The x divides out. We have to distribute. So we'll get 2x plus 8. Combine like terms. Double check to make sure nothing factors out. Remember, you can't divide these x's. 3x is connected with addition. It's not a factor by itself, so we can't divide the x's out. We are in good shape. Hopefully you're feeling pretty good, feeling all right. I have two more examples to help you kind of see what else can happen. Practice this, okay? I'm not covering every possibility here, but as long as you remember to multiply by the common denominator, multiply. It's almost off the chart there. Okay, multiply by the common denominator of every fraction. Multiply by the common denominator of every fraction in the numerator and denominator. As long as you remember to do that, multiply by the common denominator of every fraction in the numerator and denominator, you will simplify things considerably and you'll have a nice rational expression. All right, let's do two more examples, see how we feel. Hey, on any one of these, if you want to stop the video and try it yourself, and then check your work, of course, please do so. Same sort of deal. Fraction within a fraction. Let's multiply by our common denominator of everything. We need an x plus 5. Got the x plus 5. We need an x minus 3. That's going to be my common denominator of all those. Multiply top and bottom. We're really just multiplying by 1. change its appearance, not its value. Distribute. Distribute there. Divide out the x minus 3s. Distribute the 2 to the x plus 5. Get 2x plus 10. Plus, x plus 5s are gone. X minus 3. I'm noticing in my numerator, I can factor out a 3. I'm going to go ahead and do that. It might help me out. In my denominator here, I get 3x like terms plus 7. And can I factor out, can these 3's divide out? It's tempting, but this 3 is connected with the x, which is connected to addition. So this 3 is not a factor on its own. We can't divide the 3's out. So you can either multiply that back out, make it 3x minus 9, or leave it like that. I'm good either way. Either way. All right, one more. One more. Remember, multiply by the common denominators, top and bottom. It'll help out. Okay. Last one here. X over x plus 2 plus 2 over 3x divided by 5 over x squared plus 4x plus 4. Well, class, oftentimes with rational expressions, how things can get complicated or more involved is they'll give you something that needs to be factored first. And that's the case here. X squared plus 4x plus 4. We want to factor this to find out what factors are in it before we get our common denominator. So let's just do that real quick. We're in luck. It's leading coefficient of 1, so we really just have to focus on the 4. What two numbers multiply together to make 4, add together to make 4, and it's 2. So I'm going to go ahead and, even though it's a little time consuming, I'm going to rewrite all this. And I'm going to be able to write this as binomial x plus 2 and x plus 2. Now we've got to be careful here when we think of our common denominator. Because if a single denominator has multiples of something, we're going to have multiples of that something. So what I mean by that is, yeah, we need an x plus 2. We definitely need one of those as a factor. We need a 3x. But because this single fraction here has two of them, our common denominator of everything has to have two of them. Okay? I'm going to multiply that top and bottom. Just multiplying by 1, aren't we? Okay, so this is a little more involved because we're multiplying by, essentially a cubic to everything. So we might have a lot left over. Let's see, I think I've got space over here. All right, when all this distributes over, only one of the x plus 2s is going to divide out. Now, I'm just going to keep inventory of what's left to multiply to see if I can kind of minimize any mistakes. So x plus 2 will divide out this x plus 2. I'll have an x times a 3x, which I will go ahead and simplify that. That's 3x squared. But then I have another x plus 2 to multiply. So again, this times this, x plus 2's divide out. We still have an x, a 3x, and an x plus 2. Plus, when this distributes, the 3x is the only thing that divides out. So I'm going to have 2 times x plus 2, x plus 2. Hopefully that's still on the... Yeah, we're good. Okay. So that's what's left in our numerator. In our denominator, the x plus 2s all divide out. We're left with 5 times 3x, which is 15x. So from here, just take your time multiplying it out, and we'll be good. So I'll distribute the 3x squared, get 3x to the third, plus 6x squared. Now I'm going to cheat a little bit. X plus 2 times x plus 2, I know what that's going to be. It's going to be x squared plus 4x plus 4. So I'm actually going to just, well, I'll just rewrite it up here. X squared plus 4x plus 4. I'm going to distribute that 2 to all of that. So I'll get 2x squared plus 8x plus 8. All over 15x. Combine like terms, we get 3x to the third plus 8x squared plus 8x plus 8 over 15x. Now you might be concerned that this could factor. Notice we cannot factor out a monomial. That 3 kind of wrecks that. So we're not going to be able to divide anything with a monomial in our denominator. So I know that we're good. You might think, well, you've got 4 terms, and you might be thinking about factoring by grouping, and that's a good idea. But as you can see, the 3 and the 8's there, factoring by grouping is actually not going to work either. So we're in good shape here. All right, so that's a little more complicated one. Okay, the practice for this is... Page 587, numbers 31 through 36. So class, it's 6 problems, okay? Practice it. Get some practice. It helps out. Thanks for watching.